What we're going to be doing is checking out some of the more popular Linux packaging formats and running some benchmarks to see if there are any clear winners between them. But before we get into the actual benchmarking, we must first talk about what these different packaging formats are and what are some of the key differences between them. Now for this, we're going to be focusing on Flatpaks, Snaps, and AppImages. All of these have the benefit of being independent from your Linux distribution, meaning that no matter what version or distribution of Linux you are running, you can run all of these packaging formats. And this differs from something like apt, pacman, dnf, whatever it may be, because those are distribution specific package management systems. So now to cover some of the differences. First up, I'm going to talk about Flatpaks. This is a decentralized system where you can pull applications from a variety of sources, with Flathub being the most popular at the moment. The actual Flatpak applications run in a sandboxed environment, so it will be completely separate from your system's runtime. And these sandboxed applications include everything that you're going to need to run the application, including all of the dependencies. And generally, this also makes Flatpak secure because it won't actually interfere with your system at all unless if you give it explicit permission to do so. A con of Flatpaks and a lot of these compared to your distribution's native package management system is the file sizes are going to generally be a little bit larger because of all those pre-included dependencies. And then there are snap packages. Now, this is definitely the most controversial of the bunch. Snap packages are a packaging system that is developed by Canonical, the parent company of Ubuntu. And one of the big issues that a lot of people have with these snap packages is the snap store itself is proprietary and controlled by Canonical. And recently they've started replacing some of the packages on the Ubuntu system with snaps by default. And another feature of snaps is their auto-updating nature. Now, like Flatpak, snaps are also going to contain all of the dependencies needed to run the actual application, and generally it's going to be isolated from the rest of your system. Now, of these, AppImages are definitely the most interesting and unique, as they are an individual executable file that will contain everything you need to run an entire application. So there's simply just one file per AppImage, and with this, it makes AppImages incredibly portable, and with that, very easy to manage various versions of one type of application on your system. For those of you who are running Windows, a really good way to kind of compare this is these are very similar to portable .exe files that you may open and run on Windows. And AppImages are really easy to run. You just first, within permissions, make sure it is actually executable, and then click on the file to open it up, or you can launch it through the terminal. AppImage Hub is a huge repository and a great resource to find various app images and applications. And many developers who opt to actually provide this format for their applications usually have direct downloads on their websites. Now, the main issue with the AppImage format is these applications are not just directly installed on your system. So this will require more manual intervention to create desktop entries so it will show up in your menus, and of course updating them, you're just going to have to download the new version and replace it depending on how you have your system set up. But before we get into testing, we're going to have to thank the sponsor of today's video, Surfshark. Now I know that there's a lot of VPN ads on YouTube, but a lot of them are full of fluff, and I'm going to give you the two actual reasons why you might want to use a VPN provider. Let's say you are on the Ubuntu website and you want to download the ISO via a peer-to-peer download. All the people who are downloading it and everybody else really can see your public IP address. This generally is not a good thing, and that is where a VPN such as Surfshark comes in very handy, as it will mask that IP address with an IP address related to one of their many servers around the world. And then the other good reason is to get around geo blocks and geo restrictions. A lot of people talk about being able to watch Netflix of Canada while you're in the United States. Whatever it may be, it's good for that because you could connect to any of these servers around the world. Surfshark themselves has over 3,200 of these servers in 65 different countries. If you use the link down below, surfshark.deals/techhut, you can get 83% off your subscription and an extra 3 months for free. So make sure you go ahead and check the link down below. So I was browsing around on r/Linux on Reddit, and I stumbled across this posting showing a substantial difference and internet speeds between the actual snap packages and a direct Firefox download. So that got me thinking, what else can we do to see the performance differences of the same application but on different packaging formats? So first, let's take a closer look at Firefox. Now, I wasn't able to do this same internet speed test that I saw on Reddit, mostly because there is wild variations in my internet speed, and that wouldn't really be a very accurate number, but I was able to run a suite of browser benchmarks. And the very first one we ran was Basemark Web 3.0, and this benchmark includes various system and graphics tests that use web recommended features and gives us a comprehensive performance benchmark as a score so we can see the differences. Now for all of these tests, I did it on both Ubuntu and Fedora using, in addition to these various packaging formats, the APT and DNF installations. And pulling up this first graph here for Basemark Web 3.0, we can see some substantial differences between the packaging formats and in between Fedora and Ubuntu. So it's kind of a distribution comparison too, if you're interested in that. And for this was done on Firefox version 99 across all platforms and distributions. And we can see AppImages and Flatpaks are neck and neck, with AppImages performing slightly better on Fedora and Flatpaks performing slightly better on Ubuntu. And then on Fedora, Snaps actually had an advantage over the DNF installation. And then for Ubuntu, Snaps still had an advantage, but not nearly as much as the Fedora advantage. And then if we look at the native package installation versus Snap packages, Snap still had a slight advantage, particularly on Fedora, but overall with Ubuntu, it was generally neck to neck. And then from there, we went ahead and ran MotionMark, which this specifically focuses on graphic rendering. Again, this is scores, so the higher, the better. And overall, we saw very similar results. In this case, Ubuntu actually had an edge in these scores, with AppImages generally performing better than Flatpaks. And then the native package installation through APT or DNF was slightly behind the Snap package performance. And then from there, we went ahead and ran Speedometer, which just is a very general test for browser responsiveness. This one was a lot tighter. Again, we're seeing a lot of the similar results across these browser benchmarks, which generally I think is really good that these are consistent between various tests, basically telling me that these results are fairly accurate. Again, AppImages and Flatpaks are neck to neck, and with this variation of 2% down here, it's basically a tie between AppImages and Flatpaks. And with general browser responsiveness, the DNF installation on Fedora did perform substantially better than the Snap package. And then with Ubuntu, the Snap had a very slight advantage in comparison to the APT installation. Now, going forward from Firefox, there aren't too many benchmarking tools that we could use to actually measure this. So I had to kind of come up with some of my own benchmarking techniques for some of these. And the next one that we ran was just a simple Kden live render. What I did was added about an 8-minute video, added one effect to the entire thing. So it did have to do a little bit of extra work with rendering. And then right here, this is the results we got. Now this is gonna be kind of flipped from what we saw with Firefox. In this case, this is in time seconds. So the lower the score, the better. APT and DNF did substantially better than all of the cross-platform package systems. And I mean by a good margin too. If you're going to be rendering things in Kden Live, by the looks of this anyways, you should probably just install it with your system package management software. AppImage was pretty close with about a 30-second difference, but then Flat Packages and Snaps kind of lagged behind everything by anywhere from 50 to 20 seconds. And then next up, we ran one of my favorite little benchmarks, which is the GIMP Lava render. Opened up GIMP, created a 5,000 by 5,000 canvas, rendered out the lava texture, which is a slightly intensive process. Now, I do have to note the app image version of GIMP isn't kept as up to date as all the other versions. It's behind about 6 months, but even with this, app image did perform the best and actually did beat out the native installation by just about 8 seconds. And then both Flatpaks and Snap packages fell behind the native installation by a considerable margin. So just considering this graph personally, I'm going to be switching my GIMP installation to simply using an app image. And then from there, we went to a Blender image render. Now there is actually a Blender benchmarking utility, but unfortunately there's not a Flatpak Snap package and all that for that utility. So I had to download some project files directly from Blender and then render those out as a single image. My computer is not very good, so rendering out the entire animation would have taken hours. As we can see here, rendering out a single image took over 400 seconds no matter what I ran. And I did this with Flatpak and Snap packages. For some reason, the native installation on both Ubuntu and Fedora was just not cooperating with the files that I downloaded, but these are the results. And this is one of the very few cases that Snap Package is performing slightly better than Flatpaks. And this is arguable, but part of the reason for this might be that the Snap Packages are one of the download options directly from Blender, so it's one of their main supported formats. So generally from this, I can conclude that running something where you're rendering out files, doing creative work, it's probably better to use the native application from your distributions package manager. But for everything else, Flatpaks, AppImages might be better. Snaps in general kind of suck, in my personal opinion. You can voice your opinion in the comments. And if you are looking for very specific benchmarks, although these were incredibly easy to run, you could run them for yourself. Just get your latest project for whatever application you want to know runs better. Time the render process or whatever it may be, and figure out what works best for you. Big thank you to our YouTube members and Patreon supporters. You guys are also fantastic. And all these graphs and things that I talked about in this video will, like always, be linked down below. So with all that, I hope you all have a beautiful day, and goodbye.